This is going to be part 5 in my series on using Python for stock analysis, and links for those first 4 parts are going to be in the description, as well as a link out to the GitHub repository for the code. All right, so where we left off in part 4, we had just gone out and using some list of symbols that we're interested in, got the closing prices and saved those out into a file. Okay, so next up, probably what you'd want to do is maybe calculate returns from those closes, and that's how we're going to start off this video. And before I go there, I need to import NumPy. Okay, so as you can see, we're just going to quickly return the instantaneous rate of returns for all the selected securities. All right, I'm going to pass in both a folder and a file name. Okay, I want this to end sort of elegantly just in case it doesn't find the file name. So we're going to use a try and accept here. Okay, so that's what'll happen if it doesn't find a file or somehow it can't open it. And then otherwise, I'm going to set a variable, we'll call it data, and I'm going to use pandas and read that from a CSV. Okay, and then in there, I'll just call this index column. All right, and then as long as everything goes according to plan, we should be able to just sort of return our returns. Okay, and then we'll drop off that first row. Okay, should be able to test that now. So I'll just go ahead and print. And I'm going to look in that energy folder. And I'm going to look for this file that we wrote there. Okay, let's see if that works. And looks like it does work. All right, so there's, and we can just see some of them though. There, I think there are about 20 files in that folder, and we get the returns for all of them. All right, so there's lots of stuff we might want to do from here. I mean, I think probably the most obvious is we'd want to get the correlations on these. Okay, so this specific function I'm going to write to use the result of this function, all right, but there's probably a bunch of ways we'd want to write it. Maybe we'd want to get them from a file, all right, maybe the file would want to be Excel or CSV, right, so there's probably a lot of flexibility you'd want to build in here, all right, but in the interest of time, I'm just going to pass in that data, right, and then this is a pretty straightforward function, all right, I will put some documentation here. All right, but I'm just going to use the pandas core function or method. So all we need to do then here is return that data we passed in and then hang core off the end of it. All right, let's try that. And then let's see if that works. Okay, so there we have it. And yeah, they're all energy stocks. And so you can see that, well, the correlations are quite high there. You may have a different list. And then, yeah, this is certainly a valid place to start your analysis. Okay, so I might as well do one more quick function while we're here. All right, again, working with those closes, what else might you want to do? You might want to plot those closes. All right, so we'll write a function like that. And for this, I'm going to need to also import Matplotlib. All right, so we'll pass in closes and that'll turn out to be a file, and then we'll let it happen a couple of different ways. So we'll either do it relative or not. All right, so either just plot those closes against each other or plot them relative to the starting price. All right, so let's go ahead and get Matplotlib in there. All right, so this one I'll give a little bit of flexibility so we can see how to do something like that. All right, so I'll either take a CSV file or an Excel file. Okay, and otherwise it must be Excel. All right, so now we've read in our data. Now we want to know, are we plotting it relative or absolute? All right, so we'll check. Right, so by default, it'll just plot the prices as is. Otherwise, we'll have another variable here. And we'll plot the performance of each of the securities against their starting price. And we'll add a few. All right, might as well show the grid lines there to make it a little bit easier to read. All right, and up above, let's add something there too. And we'll add a horizontal line. Okay, at 0, and I'll make it red. And we'll make the line dashed. All right, and then, yeah, I'll show the grid lines there as well. Okay, let's try that. Look in this other folder, it has only a couple of stocks in there, and so the graph will look a little cleaner. Okay, we'll try it. Okay, so there it is. And yeah, there's a big discrepancy here between the prices, so it's kind of hard to look at that on the same graph. All right, so let's try it again with the relative setting to true. Okay. All right, and so there you have it. And yeah, it looks like I shouldn't have put the horizontal line at 0. I should put it at 1. All right, so that we can see what the performance is, or maybe I should subtract 1. Yeah, probably that's what I should do. All right, let me try one more thing here. We'll get up there, and once we get here, we're going to just subtract 1. All right, one more try. Okay, and so there we can see over the last year the performance of both, and yeah, right now nothing's doing very well. So there you have it. All right, so that's going to do it for part 5. In part 6, I'm going to take another swing at working with closes and changes and saving that data out to its own file. So see you there.